How do I, 44M, discuss with my SAH wife, 45F, that she needs to contribute more to the household? Guess I'll start with the basic information. My wife, 45, and I, 44, have been together 23 years, married for 18 of those. We have one child with no plans to have any more. I am semi-educated with a very good job and she has essentially no education, been working whatever job through her life that gets us by. Let's get the obvious out of the way. I love my wife, I have no want, need, plan to ever leave her. I 100% trust her and believe we will be together forever. I 100% do not believe she is cheating on me, we have a very open conversation, she can look at my phone, and does. I can look at her phone, I have. We have a very good sex life that I don't think leaves either of us wanting. So, she's cheating, I don't believe is the answer here. About 3 years ago now, wifey was going through some issues with her extended family at the same time having some back pain issues. Wifey came to me one day and wanted to discuss the possibility of being a stay-at-home mom. We decided to take some time to think about what each of us thought that meant before discussing further. About a week later we sat down to discuss this idea. I'm not sure she put much thought into it other than keep up on the house and take care of our child. I, on the other hand, had other requirements, things that I did not believe to be out of line, and still don't. Quit smoking, we simply cannot afford cigarettes on a single income. Work on self, physical self, mental self, do something that helps you be the best you can be. Household duties are yours, taking care of the house is effectively your job. I will take care of some household issues such as mowing, trimming, snow removal, maintenance, etc. Dishes, laundry, vacuuming, etc. are your duties. Control the budget, single income, we have to be very conscious about our money and where it is going. She was ecstatic and completely understanding of what I was asking. The idea of her staying at home was to make both of our lives easier. She didn't have to work, but needed to do housework. I had to work, but didn't need to do housework. Seemed like a win-win at the time. The first 6 months went great. Wifey quit smoking basically immediately, she was keeping a good eye on the budget. Lunch was regularly waiting for me and dinner plans organized. Wifey began going to the gym and really working on herself. Things were going as planned. Somewhere around that time things started to slip around the house. Dishes not done, laundry piling up. I probably made a mistake here and began helping around the house. Doing dishes at times, folding laundry. I mentioned it a few times, probably not in the most tactful way, but certainly not confrontational, regarding these being her responsibilities. Here we are 3 years into this and now I basically do dishes 80% of the time. I started doing my own laundry entirely because she gets mad, there's so much laundry for three people, the budget is out the window entirely. We barely make as much as we spend at this point. It's pretty regular that I come home and she's day drinking, napping, watching episode after episode of whatever dumb show is on Netflix. House in complete disarray. Staying up late, getting up just to take child to school, 4+ hour naps. One Saturday I finally had it. I cleaned the entire house in 3 hours and completed 4 loads of laundry. What the fuck is she doing all day? I'm gone 10 hours a day, I just don't get it. And maybe I'm oblivious, missing something, I don't know. A few months ago I started getting scared about my current job. I'd imagine it'll be good for the next 2-3 years but will then get sold out. I guarantee I will not find a position doing what I do at anywhere near the pay I am getting. Wifey just brushes it off, we'll be fine, but doesn't understand. Lately she's been discussing going back to work. With the labor shortage she can basically have her pick of jobs at around $16 per hour with benefits, which would get her off my insurance, saving us a bundle, but she hasn't even tried looking. After all this rambling, I guess my question is too long did not read. How do I talk to wifey and get across to her that she needs to do her part for the good of the house, while not coming across as a complete asshole? Quote dot. All of this has caused me to become very depressed. I come home after 10 hours at work, dishes are piling up in the sink, basement TV area has dishes and trash all over. Piles of laundry on the basement stairs to be washed, dinner nowhere in sight. So I get home from work, and start doing dishes immediately, make dinner, help my child with whatever project or just hang out with them. Eventually I get about an hour to myself to do my thing. Some days I go to the gym and just sit there doing nothing because at least I'm not at home. It's pretty regular I pull my car into the garage and just sit there listening to the end of a podcast because I just don't even want to go in the house. I often wonder if we are only together for our child, but are unable to broach that subject with the other. Maybe in 5 years when they are off to college, our relationship ends. It's not something I want, but it just feels that way sometimes. Maybe I just needed to type all this out. Sorry for the rambling post. Have a direct conversation. I never fully understand how one partner asks how do they talk to their wife husband. Sit them down. State your concerns. Say what was agreed. State how you feel the agreement had gone off track. Ask their opinion and have a conversation. If she's going to get upset and either not want to talk or turn it into a fight then, while cheating isn't the issue, you have a fundamental problem and bigger issues than you think. The question isn't, how, t, have this discussion. That's very straightforward. The main concern is why haven't you? Have you just been stewing in your feelings? I sit my husband down and, we need to talk, on much more trivial things than this. I wonder if being a stay-at-home mom was appealing at first, but the lack of social interaction can make a person very lonely and easily depressed. This could mean she's lacking a reason to keep things tidy, no friends coming over, and a reason to not nap excessively, no appointments, meetings. She needs to create a routine for herself, a daily schedule. Put the kid in group classes or play dates and get her to meet people that way. You manage to sit together and talk about implementing the stay-at-home plan. Why are you even hesitating to talk about this? First, stop doing her laundry. Your child also sounds old enough to do their own if they are off to college in 5 years. I know that won't solve everything, but it takes something off your plate. Second, I understand your reasons for not wanting to divorce, but have you considered a separation? If she is drinking during the day, you have bigger problems than you are acknowledging. You need to be okay with her being upset, even if it's for a length of time. Right now you are prioritizing her feelings when she's not concerned with yours at all. She needs to know that you aren't going to drop this, that it's not going to go away, and that she needs to make a significant change. Right now she knows that you will back down over her getting upset. Maybe she should thinking about going back to work? Her current behavior doesn't seem healthy. Could she be depressed? Probably she isn't enjoying being a SAH wife at all. Maybe she wants to have a job. Talk to her. Ask her what she wants and listen. She's sleeping a lot. Could she be depressed? It's entirely possible that the change she wanted, and perhaps needed at the time, now feels like a millstone round her neck. Also possible that she doesn't realize it. Unless divorce is on the table, she has no incentive to change. Right now, worst case, you'll bitch about it again. My M20, GF20, is being really suspicious, IDK if I'm just being paranoid. Sorry in advance, I'm new to Reddit. Background. Have been dating for 2 years, both live with our parents, still my first relationship, her second relationship. She has a big family and has a worker, let's call him Chad, who lives on the property, in a small shack a few hundred meters from the main house. He is around 6 years older than her. I always thought there were little red flags due to that situation, but I trusted her. Then a year ago she told me she had sexual feelings towards him. She is very adamant that it's only her feelings and he is none the wiser. Remember this. She then begins to explain why she would like to have an open relationship because I sometimes get scared with you and I want to know if it's just you or if I get scared with other men too, in which I then tell her I'm not at all happy with the idea. She continues to ask and pester me for the next few weeks and eventually changes her mind and agrees we shouldn't. Which I'm happy about. Fast forward 6 months, she has been working really hard and is very stressed out for multiple reasons. Along with this, she is becoming increasingly less and less intimate with me, to the point she won't kiss me. I am a very intimate person, so I find that really difficult, especially to keep a strong, close relationship with someone. I tried LDR in the past and hated it. Then a few weeks ago she tells me Chad sent her flirtatious and blatantly sexual messages, along the lines of, I saw you today and I've been hard ever since. She says she first ignores the text then tried to avoid it. Then she says a few hours later he texts and asks if she will be home alone that night. Keep in mind he knows me and while we aren't close, we see each other often when I'm over. Anyway, she tells me the same day Chad sends the messages and as you can guess, I'm quite surprised and upset. She then tells me that she can sort it out and I should stay out of it because she's a strong independent woman. When I react, asking for more information and telling her how I feel about it, she then tells me that he had been doing it for months, on and off, ever since her question about the open relationship. Should have seen that coming. Anyway, then I get upset. Keep in mind, I never so much as raise my voice. I just try voice my frustrations in a logical manner and confront her. She then replies and gets upset with, "This is why I never tell you these things, because they upset you and stress you out and I don't want you to do bad on your exams, I am a full-time med student." So yeah, ignorance is bliss I guess. I tell her she needs to tell me these things regardless because they're important. Anyway, now I'm stuck because I have no idea what to do. She made me promise to not tell her parents or mention it to Chad because he moves away in 2 weeks anyway, and she is hoping things will blow over. I'm pretty distraught and I don't know if I can trust her anymore. If I so much as mentioned it to her dad, I guarantee he would kick him out immediately. She says she's worried he will expose things about her if she exposes him to them, that's why. I've got a good relationship with the family, again it's been 2 years. I confronted her saying that she lied to me about, saying it was only one-sided and she never spoke to him about it. It was just how she felt. She then tells me, "I didn't lie. I never said anything like that to him, he said it to me." I just about got so sad when I heard that. She doesn't understand. Now I am very confused. I'm tired and I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Things seem to be pointing to her having an affair, but I feel like I'm now the bad guy for confronting her. We are in a shaky point in our relationship as it is. It doesn't look like it is going to last, which makes me sad. I've emotionally prepared myself for both scenarios, but I'm still very confused, holding on to some hope. Extra info. All these confrontations happened on the same night as I got more and more of the story. Her past relationship was abusive and none of her family knows about the abuse. She has had issues with mental health in the past. She regularly says she's not good enough for me and I deserve better. She also seems to tilt her phone away from me and won't let me look at it, which is very worrying. Sorry for the bad punctuation, I just wanted to get it out there. Edit. I have no proof she cheated apart from my gut feeling that her reason for trying to start an open relationship was to make it okay for her to sleep with him and me not be able to say anything since I agreed to it. I feel like I say this a lot on this sub, but if she broached an open relationship out of nowhere, she is either thinking of cheating or has already cheated. She is making you out to be the bad guy out of guilt. She has very likely not told you the full truth. Look up trickle truthing. Man, go with your gut. Cut her loose. Break up with her. She cheated before she asked about the open relationship. I saw you in the morning and I have been hard ever since, and if she didn't block him after that then you should have blocked her. Life is too short, man. You really want to feel like this 'cause of her? She isn't ready for a serious relationship, let her go. Maybe she cheated, maybe not, but the point is, are you sure that she actually wants to be with you? She lied. She insisted in wanting an open relationship that you clearly don't want. She openly and actively wanted to have sex with another person. I mean, finding someone attractive is okay. We are human beings, but this is different. To me, it sounds like she's not into you anymore. Sorry if I'm being rude, but something seems off. Sounds like a fun relationship, s. Confront Chad with exposure to her father unless he reveals the extent of the cheating. She's cheating. My ADHD, F25, makes me high maintenance in relationships and I don't know how to change. I'm the opposite of a boring person. I'm constantly picking up new hobbies. I'm theatrical and can talk a mile a minute about a million different interests. I learned 2 foreign languages and earned 3 degrees in my early 20s. I'm intense. I have ADHD, the hyperactive kind. People tell me I seem like I'm on cocaine sometime lol. These traits make it easy for me to find friends and partners because people find me charming and interesting easily. Here's the problem. I get bored in relationships, significant other easily, sad face. And I expect my partners to do a lot of work to prevent me from getting bored and to try and be just as interesting as me. My partner, M23, recently told me I'm the most high maintenance person they've ever dated. And the thing is, I see it. I'm a hypersexual, def a common ADHD thing, and would ideally have sex at least 3x a week. But not just any sex. Constantly changing kinky sex. They top, I top, whip out the weird ass toys, come up with off the wall dirty talk monologues constantly. Vanilla sex or the same kink for more than 3 weeks leaves me bored. I almost want to run a little porn studio from my bedroom. I can't eat the same food for more than 3 days in a row. I get bored to the point of literally feeling sick. I have to try new recipes every week. I like to be taken on an adventure every week or two. A new restaurant, a new hobby, a new neighborhood. Mix it up. Cook me an exotic candlelight dinner. Learn how to give a Thai massage. Come home with a pet snake. Entertain me. Surprise me. Of course, I'll do the same for my partner. Essentially, I feel like I have to be constantly wooed, constantly surprised. I never settle into that comfy Netflix and chill part of a relationship most people expect, where they are happy to stay in all weekend and veg. And that's exhausting for most people. On the flip side, I feel like if I dated someone as amped up and as not boring as me, it would be absolutely chaotic. So IDK what my type is or what to do? Skeptical smiley face. Any advice appreciated? Edit. Because a lot of people are asking. No, I'm not on medication. I tried Adderall and it didn't agree with me at all, and it really freaked me out. I've been putting off meds because I've been dreading potentially feeling like that again. I didn't know they could help with this, like boredom. I thought they were more for executive functioning, which lately I've been doing well at. Yes, I'm in therapy. Every other week, babby. Edit 2. I want to make it clear that I'm not hypocritical and I put in a ton of work into relationships. I don't expect my partner to woo me while I just sit back and enjoy. As an example, once I planned an impromptu vacation for us to the Middle East and bought their plane ticket. It was amazing. I put my money where my mouth is. I constantly try to plan dates. I offer to take care. Smirk of my partner frequently and expect nothing in return. I'm always looking up new recipes and new communication techniques. I consider myself a good partner. I just put in a ton of effort and energy and expect to get the same amount of effort and energy back, which maybe isn't realistic. Also, some people were telling me, get hobbies. I do loudly crying. I take 4 classes a week. I have like 5 ongoing around the house projects. Even then, it's almost never enough. Also, at least one type of class I've been taking for 1.5 years, so I can stick with hobbies. I just gave the compulsion to always add more. If I had the dollar, I'd take 10 classes a week, lol. I still crave that new. And my hobbies also energize me, so after class I'm like, bouncing off the walls, lol. Hobbies help but aren't a band-aid. I'm not trying to be cute or quirky, but I genuinely feel like I'm an interesting person with a lot of cool hobbies. If I was totally insufferable, why would I have lots of friends? It's hard to honestly say that you're an interesting person without coming off as conceited. But I get that compliment a lot. Woman shrugging, light skin tone. My friends often tell me they love hearing my wild stories. Also, I'm not like off the wall or talking a mile a minute with random strangers. Only people I'm close to and feel like I can just be myself with. I'm actually pee quiet with people I don't know well, and I'm not trying to impress. Incoming possible unpopular opinion. So I have ADHD. I do take meds and they don't all make you feel like Adderall does. I highly recommend you have your doctor try other prescriptions. However, a lot of what you describe is really just selfish behavior. You can't blame everything you do on a chemical imbalance. Some of this has to be you growing up and stopping it with I need to be wooed, I need fun, I need attention, me. I would avoid relationships until you get yourself together. Well, I also have ADHD, 43 male. I had to learn that my sexual partners aren't responsible for entertaining me at an early age. That being said, my father told something once, and I have taken it to heart. Treat someone like you want them, not like you got them, or someone else will. It means that complacency kills, and a relationship is a living construct that can die from neglect. Also, ADHD here, 27M, with very similar tendencies, but it sounds like you're using ADHD as a crutch and excuse to be a very selfish person. You need to maintain a level of self-discipline to overcome urges that are more prevalent among people with ADHD, instead of just saying, sorry, it's my ADHD. The world doesn't care about our ADHD. You need help. It seems like you're taking zero accountability and find these quirks cute. Are you taking any of these initiatives? Are you planning an elaborate adventure every other week, and you expect your partner to go in the off weeks? Do you exercise? It sounds like you need to pick up a hobby. Some kind of adventure sport, and then just hyper-focus on that. I dated a super ADHD dude, and we made things work by developing a few shared adrenaline passions which he could pursue in his own time. But this mentality of having to be catered to is super toxic. A partner isn't just there to entertain you. You're an adult, you need to learn to entertain yourself, and then a partner can enrich your life. Are you on medication? Reading this was fucking exhausting and gave me anxiety. The way you describe yourself and your behavior sounds less like ADHD hyperactivity and more like mania. Please get on medication and get your shit together. You're clearly a productive adult, which is great, coming from someone with the kinds of executive dysfunction that keep me from being as productive as I'd like some days. But you clearly still need to do a lot of work on yourself. It's not healthy to try to find partners and then expect them to keep up with you or change themselves so you don't get bored. Your little quirks can be damaging and it seems like you're not taking accountability. So to me, this is an issue with your ADHD not being managed or addressed, not your relationships. Go back to your psychiatrist and let them know that Adderall makes you aggressive and see what the alternatives are. You sound out of control, and super proud of it. You list off all the ways you exhaust your partners and don't talk at all about any intention to try to change. People like you are beyond annoying and easy to spot from a mile away. Find a way to get that validation internally, honey. This isn't the way. In another decade, you're going to be attracting really gross men because they know people like you don't have many options. My girlfriend is separated and says she loves me, but I don't fully believe her. I know. We've heard it all before. Nice guys finish last. I'm someone who genuinely loves humanity. I love to see people happy, alleviated from pain, grow wealthy and succeed. I'm not perfect, but if I had one thing to boast about, it's how I treat people. However, I've been in many relationships now and there's one thing that they've all had in common. They can't let go of the guy who cheated, emotionally manipulated or made them cry. My current girlfriend is absolutely incredible in every way. She's a genius and I'm not using that loosely. She cooks, cares for her pet like no other, has great fashion and furniture taste, is a great storyteller, God, so many great qualities. But, of course, nothing is perfect. She's separated and currently going through a divorce. Her husband of 5 years cheated on her 8 times with prostitutes, escorts and women he picked up from bars. They're currently in the process of selling a condo. From what she's told me and him are nothing alike. He's never assisted her with cooking, cleaning, driving, taking care of the dog, house payments. He just came from a good family and he's a bit of a black sheep. However, she always talks about moments she had with him and her family, and again, nearly every woman I've let into my life does the same thing. Women in my life never talk about the guy who held the door, gave them flowers, or did kind things. They all seem to dwell on the guy they couldn't have. I found out that last week my girlfriend texted him and told him that she loved and missed him, and sent him a video of the dog. Apparently when they divorced, he wanted to put the dog up for adoption. I've never received a video of the dog yet I walk him, feed him, .idk. I don't want to feel this way, but it seems like people truly enjoy being treated like crap because it gives them a challenge, when in my opinion, it's actually easier to take on a challenge than it is to cultivate something that's already good. It's easier to improve than it is to maintain, in my opinion. I get a sick feeling in my gut when I'm confronted with temptation, when I'm in a position to hurt others. Maybe that's weakness in itself. She's from a third world country, is very loving and I understand that he introduced her to a lot of American ways. But how could someone still love someone after all of that? I'm a scorched earth kind of man myself. When deceived and hurt in such a way, you're removed from my consciousness. You're invisible. Yesterday she cried to me and told me profusely how much she loved me and asked me to marry her. But actions are louder than words and I need to see that. IDK if this is the right place, but I can't eat or work without getting this out. I appreciate this sub. I also want to say that I'm truly trying to be empathetic to folks that stay with partners that treat them like garbage, but it's very difficult. Insight in this behavior is truly appreciated. Thanks again. She asked you to marry her before she even got out of her previous marriage with the ex she just told she loves and misses? My God, please tell me you see all the red flags here. You sound like you are trying to nice guy your way into a relationship and she's going to use you as a placeholder until her ex comes back or she finds someone else. There is no happy ending in this relationship for you. LMAO wow, you spent so long blowing your own horn I lost the plot. If that's the women you met and no woman has talked about those things, in your life, it's your taste. Just a small word of advice. Drop the, I'm a nice guy, shtick. Smart women can see the desperation you're giving off. Nice guys don't finish last. Boring guys finish last. She is emotionally unavailable to you right now, and her feelings for you will probably change after the divorce. That's very common. Call it a lifeline or some kind of support thing. You should really protect yourself for this situation. They rarely turn out well. I have seen it work, and those friends of mine have been together for 10 years now, so I am not saying it doesn't happen. I found out that last week my girlfriend texted him and told him that she lived and missed him. Sue. You told her to pack her bags and go to him if she loves him so much? Your girlfriend sounds like she has her own shit to work out. In the meantime, you might consider going to therapy. I don't want to throw around words like, savior complex, white knighting, but I also don't not want to. Doesn't mean you're not a good guy who genuinely cares for people, but if you find yourself in this circumstance over and over, you probably have some underlying thought processes that are making them so attractive to you. Being with someone who doesn't need a rescue might even feel boring to you, after a bunch of chaos-filled relationships, but I promise it will be more rewarding than feeling this angst.